Florida, Lieutenant Governor Jennifer Carroll.
And one thing that's important too for our students, and I came up through the hard way as well, being a jet mechanic, coming up not through the books, but through on-the-job training. These students will be able to get both application in the classroom and have the practical application so that when they come out with their degree program, the certificate, they're able to go right to work. And that's what Rick Scott, Governor Scott, and I are all about, is moving the process so that we have a pipeline of the training and education to make sure we have a viable workforce at the end of that. And that's what this program represents. This is a good opportunity for many other local municipalities to watch this as an example as to how the public-private partnership can work to, number one, educate our workforce, and number two, create jobs and have a productive future for individuals coming out of our education system.
So it's most appropriate and most welcome to have Congressman Stearns with us today. Congressman.
I tried to distill this whole thing into perhaps one or two sentences, and this is what I came up with. We are in a unique position, in a unique facility in all of the United States, not just Jacksonville area, nor Central Florida or the South, but in all the United States, a public, and as the President said, a public-public, private, academic partnership, combining aircraft maintenance, painting, and coding, coding in a way that is not just normal coding, but special coding in an educational environment. Experience based upon practical application training. So when you go into this with an educational facility giving you practical application training is unique. And so this provides students access to large frame aircraft like the 757 behind us. And this facility is one of the reasons Cecil Field has become the most successful post-BRAC military base in the entire United States, with a full transition to business. In fact, every available square foot here has been leased out. It's 1.3 million square feet. So this means jobs for Jacksonville and for North Central Florida.
Mr. Grossman is the CEO of the Jacksonville Aviation Authority, and he's also the Chief Executive Officer. And I think you've been here. That's enough.
I mean, first of all, you've heard, we are preparing youth for careers in aviation. That, I think, is one of the most important things about this partnership. We are strengthening the Jacksonville labor force for aerospace companies, an important element of why they come here. We are providing needed services here at Cecil. I was with a major defense contractor the other day, and I can't tell you who it was, Boeing. They were talking about, they talked to communities all over the country. Most of those communities don't really get it, because what companies like them are looking for are services that they need that they would ordinarily have to provide themselves, that in communities like Jacksonville, they don't have to. So, you know, they talked about some of the great services that our FBO Jetport here provides for them. They talked about that now, with this paint facility, they can rely on Flightstar to cover some of those needs for them. And so again, it makes Cecil Airport a much more viable place for these companies to come. And so we are looking at other services that need to be here to attract those companies. It gives us a step up on everybody else. You know, the city of Jacksonville and the authority have jointly targeted aerospace as a sector we want to see grow. And obviously we want to see it grow because of the jobs and the quality of the jobs that it brings. We are seeking to enhance the authority's role as a major economic engine for this entire region. One way to accomplish that is through development of our property, particularly our airside property, with companies like Flightstar, that once we get them here, they grow. Other companies see that and they want to be in the same place. And so it just
State College in Jacksonville, Jacksonville Aviation